What's up, everybody? It is Mary Beth Eversole, the allergy actress, and I am here today with my very special guest, Bridget Cattell.
Thank you.
And she is, yeah, good to have you here. She is the creator and executive producer of a radio show and a reality television show that's in development right now.
Correct.
That's wonderful. We are here today to talk about a myriad of topics. Including organizing your kitchen, efficiency in the kitchen, and how to make food that is good for you but also quick. So if you're in a job where it's just on the go all the time, like a firehouse, you can still eat well and eat quickly. So with that in mind, what are we making today?
We're making Firehouse vegetarian chili.
Heck yeah. And it's, oh, you guys, it
yummy.
Already smells so good in here. Smell-o-vision. Oh, I wish we had it. All right, so without further ado, let's get to the ingredients. First, we've got
The
zucchini and the eggplant. Now, the recipe calls for just eggplant, correct?
Correct.
But I love zucchini, and I'm not as huge of a fan of eggplant, although I am becoming one.
Good.
And I've never tried it in chili, so I'm really excited about this.
Yeah, it's excellent.
Yeah, so we've got one small eggplant, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And then one zucchini. And we just diced it up and threw it in there. So
yeah, just
that.
A small dice.
All right, so next we have the 4 cups of veggie broth. And this is store-bought that I bought today. And I mean, I kind of did it because we're talking about meals on the go, fast meals.
Something like this, you can make it ahead of time. And a lot of people put the pressure on themselves to mm-hmm. create these dishes all the same day.
Yeah, no.
But something like this, you can make the broth ahead, like you said,
exactly.
And freeze it.
Yeah.
So make it yourself if
and
you
really
want
to. And it'll last. When it's frozen, it lasts for a long time. And especially, you know, they have those like vacuum sealer things now where you can vacuum seal the liquids for a long time. It's great. So okay, next
lentils.
We've got green today, 1 cup of green, but we can use other colors, right?
We can use yellow, we can use orange,
brown,
and you said the red takes
the
a little longer?
The red takes, it's shorter. The red is
shorter.
A shorter amount of cook time. So if you're going to use red lentils, just use red lentils. Don't use all of them because they're different cook times.
Correct.
But the rest of them, they go together. So then we have a 15-ounce can of diced tomatoes. And you can, of course, again, I got the organic canned tomatoes and from the same allergy-friendly grocery store. And it's really, you know, again, if you're on the go, just get the can, you know, check your ingredients, make sure there's not a lot of preservatives in there, and then just go, you know. So the most they should really be using is like salt and tomatoes, you know. When I can tomatoes, that's mm-hmm. what you put in. You put a little bit of sugar too. You put a little sugar, a little
sugar
salt
for the acidic
tomatoes. You can it, put it on your shelf for the winter, and voila, you've got it. Canning takes a little bit of time, but if you've got the time, can it, put it on your shelf, and then you, along with the broth, and you're set. You can make chili all winter, you know.
And really pay attention to how they peel their tomatoes.
Yeah.
Whether it's, what do they call it, flashed?
Yes. Yeah.
You know, steam flashed.
Yep. Yep.
Or they do it with lye. So really be careful when you're buying these.
Yeah, yeah. Make sure you know, again, sustainably sourced. Know where your food is coming from. So, okay, next we have onions. And it's just one small yellow onion, or we could use, I know it's like, woo!
You can tell there's onions in the house.
I'll tell you what, when I was chopping these up, I was crying so bad. Like, I walked out to my husband and I was like, sweetie! And he was like, did you cut yourself? And I'm like, no, I'm cutting an onion. So, that one. And then we have one really nice bell pepper. We chose red for today. But you could use any bell pepper. Okay, so then we have our spices. So this is the cocoa powder, yes?
Yes. Or as you call it?
As a cacao! Cacao! And so, so this was, I believe, 6 teaspoons of cocoa powder.
Correct.
And what are we using the cocoa powder for?
The cocoa powder is in there to bring a little sweetness, but it's also to cut the heat of the jalapeno peppers. A lot of people don't realize that you can do really hot spices, but if you add a little cocoa powder, it'll really cut it. And years ago, I was eating at a Mexican restaurant, and I ordered a dish, and they brought it out, and it was brown. And when I tasted it, it tasted like cocoa powder, and I thought the chef had messed up the recipe.
Yeah.
So the waiter finally told me I was a knucklehead, and that was the sauce that came with cocoa powder in it.
Oh, well, nice. Nice waiter, but learn something new every day, right? So, okay, so then we have this is...
Is it cumin?
Yes. Mm. And I say cumin, and she says cumin. You know, you say tomato, I say tomato.
I love it all.
Right? It smells so, so good. 3 teaspoons of cumin. And that's another spice. And it does. It brings some heat. So it's a different kind of heat than the chili powder.
Correct.
But it does bring a little bit of heat. So you've got to be ready for that, okay? Cut down on the cumin if you don't want it to be as spicy. And cut down on the chili powder, too. So, which, speaking of chili powder, let's do that one next. Mm-hmm. It's the powder that makes it hot. And there are 5 teaspoons of this chili powder. Yeah, that's a lot.
That's a lot.
That's a lot. So if you're not so huge on the spice, just cut down. Cut down on the chili powder, okay?
Or add more cacao.
Or add more cacao! Okay. So so then we have oregano. And yes. So there is 1/4 cup of fresh oregano. Mm. You can use dried, but fresh is better. All right?
So what are we going to do next? Our garlic?
Yeah, let's do the garlic. What's up, garlic? We've got 2 cloves of garlic. What's up, garlic? 2 cloves of garlic, and garlic is garlic, you know. It's good. It's a detoxifier. It can, you know, seep through your pores. So if you're on a date, I wouldn't recommend, if you like the date, don't eat the garlic. If you don't like the date, order more.
And if you like the date, make them eat the garlic.
Okay. So then we have our coriander, right?
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, coriander. Coriander is it's like the friend that's left outside of the circle, you know, but it's so kind and it's so nice and it tastes so good. It's got a little bit of a nutty flavor, but it's just not included in the cool crowd. But I think coriander's really cool. Okay, and then let's say we've got, we've got the cinnamon. Now this is something I didn't think to put in chili.
Never. I would have never thought of adding cinnamon to a chili.
Yeah, but it's good, so yay. And it's just a little bit, 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon. It's not that much, but it's just a hint of the cinnamon. So yeah. And then of course, with every good anything that you ever cook, you want to make sure that you have salt and pepper. Now we're using kosher salt here because, well, frankly, it's better than table salt. I also like bigger chunks, and I feel like kosher salt is more flavorful. I've used it in a lot of things, mm-hmm. and it brings the flavor up more. The minerals are left in there. The only thing that I would think would be a different salt that would have as many or more minerals would be that pink Himalayan salt. Yeah. Okay, so then we've got our oil.
Last but not least.
The avocado oil is so, so good for you. It's a wonderful, wonderful fat. It can replace olive oil in anything that you cook. It's got a really high heat point, so you can saute with it. You can do anything that you would do with olive oil or any of those high heat oils. And it's got I think it has a more robust flavor. I like it.
Yes.
So I like that a lot. Okay, last but not least, let's bring the heat. If we didn't have enough already, let's bring some more. Jalapenos, everybody. Jalapenos. So this is just 1 jalapeno, and it's minced. Mince it. Because if you just chop it, you're going to get a big old bite of jalapeno and you'll never eat the chili again unless you're a huge fan of really hot spice. So
unless you have the cacao.
The cacao, yes. You'll be pouring it in your mouth. So, but yeah, and again, if you find you put your chili together, you're tasting it, and you find that it's too hot, put more cacao in there. Cacao! And then it'll bring down the heat.
It'll bring it down, yeah.
Yeah. So I think we've covered everything, yeah?
I think we got it all.
Fantastic. All right, on to the main event, y'all. It's time to assemble the chili.
Yes.
I'm so excited. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to do the oil, and you're going to warm that up. And I've already preheated the thing a little bit, but there we go. And this cool stove has a power burner, so it can go like really, really fast. But if you don't have that, just start out on, I'd say, medium. To get the oil kind of and coat the bottom of your pan before you put the eggplant in. And then we're going to put the eggplant and zucchini mixture in. And go like that. So, and then feel free, you may stir.
Can we turn it up just a little bit?
Absolutely. And then you may stir. And while you're stirring, I would love for you to talk a little bit about the kitchens. And I can help you stir, too.
Crappy kitchens?
Oh, yeah.
Want to start with crappy kitchens?
Yeah. Let's start with crappy kitchens. Tell the audience. Tell them. I'm sure you've had experience with the like seeing, because just being in producing the show that you're producing, I'm sure right. you've seen quite a few crazy things.
I think the most important thing when it comes to crappy kitchens is to realize that a kitchen is the heart of the home. It creates the memories. Mm-hmm. It's the place that we, you know, heal our souls and it's for our bodies and
it's where family gathers.
Family gathers and everything.
And for those of us with allergies, I will just say that makes it so terribly difficult. You feel very isolated. And I got depressed when I was first diagnosed because I didn't know what was safe. And I didn't feel safe going to parties and trying people's foods or having people come over and I make food, even making large quantities of the food. I don't know. It just stressed me out. And I felt very disconnected from my friends and family for a while because it didn't feel safe. And so, but having an organized kitchen, an efficient kitchen, is so helpful. So you have some really helpful tidbits to avoid a crappy kitchen. So,
well, one of the most important things, this TV show I've been all over the country for the last 5 years developing, is I really learned from firefighters that there's more chemicals in house fires now than ever before. And most of the chemicals are in the kitchen.
Yeah.
So if you think about it, because of just all the cleaners and the crazy stuff that we use throughout our house. So it's really crucial to get all those chemicals out of your kitchen. Mm-hmm. And there's been so many commercial and residential kitchens I've worked on that I see just inappropriate stuff in a kitchen. I've seen kitchens where the guys have had their work tools and chemicals and glues in the kitchen.
Yikes.
So you really need to get them out of the kitchen and use safe, clean products, or I should say safe and secure products for cleaning.
Like
lemon is excellent. Baking soda. But another thing a lot of people don't realize is you can use salt and a pumice stone to really get hard stains off in that. So there's all kinds of healthy, white vinegar is great for calcium buildup.
I've actually used apple cider vinegar and it's worked okay. So
apple cider.
There's going to be a vinegary smell for a little while, but it's so much better than having a chemical smell.
It's worth it.
You know? Or worse yet, getting a chemical burn. I mean, those and it's safe for kids, you know. If your child ingests some white vinegar, they're not going to have to go to the poison control center, you know, the emergency room.
And you're seeing a lot of these laundry pods that you drop into your laundry. Kids are ingesting them. So, I mean, you really have to, there's really healthy alternatives that are safe. Especially if you have allergies or stuff like that.
And it's stuff you can find already in your house.
Correct.
You know?
Correct.
So, okay. So
or
then
simply go to the store. And then there's other things like I've seen where, you know, you have your oven over here and your oven mitts over there. And the oven mitts are those thin, cheap ones. And you burn yourself. So many burns take place.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's awful. Yeah. So invest in the pot holder because, I mean, think about it. You're sticking your hand into 450 degrees.
Correct.
How is that metal not going to be it's going to be hotter. It's withholding the heat. It's going to be even hotter.
Exactly.
You're touching it with cloth that's the size of this. I mean, come on.
And expecting not to get burned.
Yeah. So invest. Invest in those awesome, awesome pot holders. And then the knives.
Well, that's another thing is, I hate to say it, but having crappy knives. Yes, it seems crazy to spend $100 for a knife, but it is so worth it. And broken down appliances and, you know, wrong ventilation, so it's not ventilating the crate.
Ventilation is very important.
And there's so much asbestos in old floors. So you really have to think about your floors and your cabinets. Mm-hmm. I mean, this is hazardous, but it's also unhealthy.
Right.
All the chemicals that are just in these old kitchens.
Well, yeah, and the sharp objects. I mean, I know we all have, like, kind of a catch-all drawer for the weird spoons.
Cooking utensils
that we don't know what to do with, so we throw them in a drawer. But a lot of those are really sharp. And if you're cooking and you're not paying attention, you go to reach, you could cut a finger off.
Correct.
I mean, you know, you could stab yourself. It's not to scare you guys. I don't want to be scary, but we do want to talk about being smart.
But I see it over and over.
You know, being smart. And she is purposely going into Firehouse kitchens and helping to get them renovated so that they can avoid these injuries, avoid the illnesses caused by the chemicals or the fire with the chemicals, you know.
Well, the greatest thing I've seen with this TV show I'm developing, it's going to be renovating working fire stations all over the country, is so many of these fire stations are old. So literally, in the fire station, they have asbestos floors.
It's a death trap.
The old. So people don't realize that the places the firefighters call home are injuring them and actually killing them, which there's over 100 firefighters that die every year under the age of 55 from heart problems, from the systems that wake them up and the asbestos and not having poles on two stories. So there's so many things you don't realize in a kitchen.
This is such an important show and a cause that you're doing, and I'm so glad that you've come on the show today to talk about it. Because, I mean, firemen, there are heroes. They run in when everybody else is running out, and I know that's a cliche and it's said all the time, but it's true.
It is.
And why? Why would they put themselves, why? There's no need for them to put themselves in danger beyond what they're already doing. You
exactly.
know, they deserve a safe and cozy place where they can get good meals and sleep okay and all of that
exactly.
without the further health issues or the stress or all of that. So.
And that looks like they're doing pretty good right now,
yeah.
about 5 minutes.
Yeah, we're cooking it down. So we've gone about 5 minutes with this. And on to the organization. So you talked about how, you know, it really makes sense. You want to think about, if you're planning a kitchen, you want to think about how it's laid out. If you are in the planning stages where you can actually build a kitchen, that's best, because then, you know, put your stove next to where you're going to be dumping out the stuff, you know, like get a water spigot thing so you don't have to carry the big old pot over here, you know, if you can afford to do that. If you can't, figure out the layout. What am I going to put in this drawer? Well, most likely I'm either going to want one of these things that holds all the utensils so I can easily reach without having to burn myself or, you know, walk away from the food and it boils over, or put it in a drawer next to you as long as it's not sharp, and organize in your drawer so that you're not digging around while you're
And you really want to organize a cutting specifically, and the best place is next to a sink.
Yeah.
And when you set up your cutting area, you really want the knives up on a magnet on the wall. People, you really
That's
need to
a good
stop
idea.
Putting knives in drawers. So many accidents happen with knives in drawers, and you slip your hand in to go get the knife, and you slice your hand on the knife. The best thing is a magnet up against the wall, and make sure if you've got a designated cutting area, everything is there. You know, next to your oven, make sure you have good thick mitts.
Yeah.
Make sure it's set up, you know, you have the proper dishes and where they should be.
Yeah.
Because you don't realize, just having it organized, how crucial that can be.
Well, and I mean, going upon that with food allergies, if you're celiacs, which is, they cannot have cross-contamination with any kind of gluten, which, by the way, gluten floats in the air with flour, and it sticks to things like this pot. If I were cooking a glutinous meal, I wouldn't be able to cook for a gluten-free person because it's porous, and so it sucks up the gluten, and you will never be able to wash that out. So as someone with celiacs or someone who has gluten sensitivities, or even someone like me, I cannot cross-contaminate if it's soy or corn. I just can't. It makes me very, very ill, and I end up in the hospital. So what I do at home is I have a designated cabinet for myself, for all my flours and all of my, you know, because I'm allergic to wheat as well. And everything, and then I have a designated shelf in the fridge that's for me, and I usually have it up at the top so that if there's any foods from my husband, like meats or anything like that, they're not dripping down onto my food. And that's, I mean, that's that way. That's just common sense as far as put the meats down at the bottom, you guys, because, you know, if there's salmonella and or if there's a little bit of blood that escapes from the meat coming out, you don't want that stuff spilling all over your food.
And put it in a bowl.
Yeah.
Or put it in like a baking dish or something like that. And something I've really seen is to help with that is if you're going to store something, a lot of times it's just use a Ziploc bag so it can be thrown away.
Yeah, exactly. I use Ziploc
bags. Versus the plastic, like you said, that's porous.
Yep. So, okay, this looks pretty good. These are cooked down pretty well.
You want me to stir and you can add the rest?
Yeah, okay. All right. So now we're going to add the spices. All right. Ooh,
yum.
Are you ready? I'm so ready.
Cumin, throw that in first.
Where are you, cumin? So,
it smells so good.
Okay, sprinkle it. Try to sprinkle from above because that gets it to be more spread out. And then you want to do the, here's the chili powder. Here comes the hot. Plug your nose. I know they have those cooking shows where they try the really, really, really hot foods, and like people will put stuff in the blender, and the chefs will actually be like, stand back. You don't want to be standing over this because you could burn your nostril hairs. This isn't that hot, but you don't want to be leaning over as you're pouring chili powder into your chili because you will get a little, you know. So.
Yeah, these are not ghost peppers or habaneros.
Yeah, which is a good thing. So, okay, so we're going to add the coriander.
But if you like that heat, you can add it.
Yeah, you could. Add it. Okay. And then you add, so here comes the, cinnamon. Just a little bit, but it just adds that little kick, you know. Who doesn't love cinnamon? I love cinnamon. Okay, and then here comes the heat stopper. The cocoa powder.
No, it's not cocoa powder. It's...
Oh, cacao! Cacao powder!
Oh my God, I'm going to hear that in my sleep now.
Well, you got to do the action. Cacao! Okay, and then you want to add the oregano. Ba-ba-ba-bum. Yeah, you stir that in really well. And then...
oh my God, it smells so good already.
You guys! This smells so good. This is the best smelling chili I've ever had.
Okay, it looks like mud, but it smells good.
Right, yeah. So here comes the onion. And then we're going to do the bell pepper.
Okay.
Remember, any color bell pepper is great.
Or mix it up. Do
mix
a little bit of each color.
All the colors. And then, although I would just say green has a different flavor palette than all the others. So I don't mix them.
It's not as sweet.
So there went the garlic. And last but not least is the real heat, the jalapenos, which again, you want to put ghost peppers in there, you go right ahead. So, would you mind doing the spoon action?
Yes.
All right, there we go. Okay, so then.
About 4 minutes, you want to just stir it, get it all tender. Well, that's good.
Kind of stuck to the bottom there. All right. So then you're going to do this, you want to wait until like the jalapenos and the onions soften. When the onions have softened, you'll see them turn a little translucent, more clear, rather than white. So that's when you'll know that they're done. And while we're waiting for them to turn...
The cocoa powder and the cinnamon.
Gosh. Okay.
I would have never thought of adding either one of those to a chili. Ever.
I'm going to do that from now on. Okay, so then while you're doing that, I want you to tell me a little bit more about your show, because first of all, how did you come up with the concept?
Well, I have a dear friend who's a fire captain.
Okay.
And I cooked at a couple of the kitchens he was stationed at, and this one small little kitchen in Canyon Country, I went there and had dinner with him about 2 weeks before Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
And we were talking at dinner, and I was asking him about their Thanksgiving dinner they were going to make. And he said, well, we had to buy it. And I said, well, why'd you have to buy it? And he said, our kitchen had fallen apart and our oven doesn't work.
Oh my gosh, their oven didn't work?
No, and they had a brand new oven sitting out in their garage. But
they probably didn't ever have time to get it in there.
Well, it was like this whole budget thing, you know, being able to afford to put it in.
Yeah.
So it bothered me for about 2 weeks. And then I called my friend, David. He built three homes for Extreme Home Makeover show.
Ooh, good show.
And I thought, well, I know David's got a big heart, and we both belong to the same Rotary Club. So I called him up, and I said, I had that harebrained idea to renovate Mark's station. Surprise him, and he said, anything for our firefighters.
Yes, anything for the firefighters.
So
thank you, firefighters. Good men. Good men.
I love you guys.
Women. Good men and women. So, all right. That looks pretty good.
Looks good.
Yeah. It's, okay. So, again, like I said, when you look in the pot, you're probably going to see it from above. Hi.
How's it looking?
Right?
Looks like mud in there.
Everything is covered, but it smells so good.
Oh my goodness.
And the onions are starting to become a little more clear. And the peppers. And again, this is going to cook for 40 minutes. So if they're not totally tender, you don't want them to be that way, because then they'll become like bleh. So
they'll cook in the simmering process.
Right. So okay. So next comes the lentils. And you haven't done anything to them. They're just dry lentils, and you just pour them in.
Aren't you supposed to rinse them off and pick out the stones?
Yes. Yep.
Okay. Did we do that?
I did, yes. I did.
Do you have stones in there?
No, I think there were the stones. That was actually a really good package. It really didn't have anything that was stony in it.
Good.
Yeah. You don't want to end up with those stones in a bite, because you will break your tooth. So you just got to be careful about that. And then along with this, you want to add the vegetable stock. Here it comes. And in we go. Veggie stock. Now, if you don't, another way that you could make veggie stock is by getting vegetable bouillon and water. and that works too.
I find a lot of them have a lot of sodium.
Some of them do, but there are some really good low sodium vegetarian bouillon cubes that are soy and corn free, believe it or not, that are from a very excellent allergy-friendly grocery store. It starts with an S and it ends with a TS. And it sounds like...
I have no idea.
Cows. So...
So you want to go ahead and bring this up to a boil.
Okay.
And then we'll cover it and then we'll simmer it for 40 minutes.
Awesome. Okay, so bringing it to a boil and then we cover it, bring it down to a simmer, and it's covered for 40 minutes. And then it's ready for tasting.
Yes.
So, okay, so just don't forget to turn the heat down. Okay, turn it up to bring it to a boil. Turn it down to simmer, low simmer, for 40 minutes. If you don't, you will have burnt to the pan chili. So
you'll have paste.
Right.
You'll have chili paste.
Right, exactly. So that's it. I just want to say thank you so much for sharing about your show. And I'm looking forward to seeing it. I really hope it gets off the ground and that you're able to go help as many firefighters as possible. So while this cooks, we are going to just hang out and we'll see you on the flip side for the tasting.
Yum.
Okay, so this is hot.
Hot.
So we're going to blow on it. And then we're going to take a bite.
Hot temperature.
See what this tastes like. It's hot,
hot
and
temperature.
It's spicy. So here we go. Love good chili facial in the evening. Yep. I think that says it all.
And I love the eggplant in it. It gives it that kind of meaty texture. Mm-hmm. So you're really not missing it.
Yeah, and I can taste the, I just got a bite of zucchini. What's nice about it is it's cooked just right, so you can still taste the freshness of the zucchini without it being overcooked. Because sometimes you get the overcooked vegetables and it's lost all of its flavor, you know? And I can taste the cacao.
And it's interesting, you can taste the cumin, you can taste the tomatoes, mm-hmm. you can taste the lentils, you can really taste all the different flavors mm-hmm. that are
But
in
it comes together really well in a cohesive dish.
Yeah.
So, and I think you mentioned to me that this could be used cold.
Yeah, this makes an excellent cold dip.
Uh-huh.
So this is excellent for a Super Bowl. You can mm-hmm. have a lot of fun with this, and you can have all the different side fixings if you like. The cheese, sour cream.
Oh, this would be nice, yeah.
Cilantro on this, jalapenos. So you can really dress it up any way you want to.
That's awesome. Get some good crackers with the gluten-free crackers.
Yes.
Maybe some vegan cheese or goat cheese, because I can do goat cheese, so.
Yeah.
But yeah, oh my gosh, this is, thank you so, so much for bringing this recipe. It's so good.
You're welcome.
So Bridget, please tell me, how can my audience reach out to you? Where can they find out more information about your shows and about what you're doing?
They can reach us at Fire Station Renovation. It's FSR Productions.
Okay.
At AOL.com.
Fantastic. And just reach out to you? Reach out
yes.
to Bridget? Okay.
My cell phone number? Yes? No?
Eh.
No?
Eh.
You got it. You got it.
So, and yeah, so I'm looking forward to seeing where your show goes. I really hope it takes off. And because it's these guys, these men and women, they put their lives on the line and they need it. They need some of that comfort and some of that, they need that pressure to be taken off so that they know that they're being fed well so they can do their job well, you know?
They need our help.
Yeah.
They need to help us while they're helping save our homes and our lives.
Absolutely. So, all right. Well, this is a fantastic chili. Cheers to you.
Cheers to chili.
Yep.
Firehouse chili.
Firehouse chili. This is Mary Beth Eversole, the allergy actress, with guest Bridget Cattell, signing off for now.